In today's session, we will be looking into the concept of steady state errors. Okay. In the previous session, we have seen some of the problems based on time response. Okay. In the previous session, we have seen few of the problems based on time response. Some two sessions we have spared on the problems. So please try to have more practice on the problems. Today we will be covering the topic steady state errors. This is not a unknown topic to you, because when we dealt with the first order system and second order system, remember at the end when we found from C of S, we have got C of T. That is, this is your Laplace transform of the output, and applying the inverse Laplace transform, we got C of T. After finding C of T, we have gone for error calculation. So, for example, if I tell input R of T is your unit step, okay? Under that, R of T, which is 1, okay? If I take its Laplace transform, it is equal to 1 by S, okay? We have seen this already. And at the end, C of T, we have got something like 1 minus some value, and this minus value, ye jo second term hai, this is our error term. We have calculated. You can just look back after the session. Just try to turn the pages and look back. While calculating the second order system output, we have got C of T is equal to 1 minus exponential divided by root of, and then tan inverse sine, right? So this second term is your error, and we can find steady state error. I had told you already regarding this. Using final value theorem, we can find the steady state error. So this is not an unknown term to you. But however, for different set of inputs, we will look into this topic. What is this steady state error? If I take unit step, what is the value? If I take ramp, what is the value? If I take parabolic, then what is the value? Okay. So it's not an unknown term to you. So talking about this concept, steady state errors. Okay, let me first explain you about this. You know what is a steady state? Generally, a response is divided into two categories. That is, sum, complete response is sum of transient response and steady state response. So what is a steady state? When you apply the input to any system, you know, suddenly system will not work, right? Whenever you go for any system input application, it will take some time. It will give you certain output, and whatever output you get, it will be oscillatory in nature. Wo ekdam se constancy mein nahi aayega. It will take some amount of time to reach that steady state value. And this we call it, this is your transient response. This is your steady state response. We have already seen all these things. Now talking about steady state error. The error that we encounter in order to reach steady state. So system steady state pe nahi aayega because of existence of this error. Agar ye error zero ho gaya to aapka system steady state mein aa jayega. That is called a steady state error. So the steady state errors, they constitute an extremely important aspect of system performance. Kitna error aapka system dega, it is a very valid part. It is very important for any designer to look into this errors part. Okay, it is a measure of system accuracy. Aapka system kitna well accurate hai, kitna accurately aapko output deta hai, it is the measure of that. So these errors, jo bhi errors arise honge in your any designed system, control systems, there may be different reasons for these errors. They may be from natural inputs, jo bhi aap inputs de rahe hain system ko, uski wajah se thode bahut errors arise honge. Or type of the system, what kind of system you are taking, type 0, type 1, we will be studying in the next concept, type 0, type 1, type 2 system. Then some non-linearities in the system components. What are these non-linearities? They are friction element. For example, agar aap mechanical system le rahe ho, inside you get into different components. And whenever you apply any input, so the machines and all the components, they start working. So it may happen that these components, they get this, they result in the friction. which you never you had not expected while designing. So because of the frictional part also, sometimes you get the errors. And the backlash. What is the backlash? The meaning of backlash? It is the reaction by the system, right? For example, agar aap apke system mein mechanical system hai, samjho aap spring use kar rahe ho, okay? Spring component hai. So you are applying some input and this spring is, it is used in your system for some specific purpose, okay? Toh system mein aap jab spring use kar rahe ho, you are applying some input to it and it will work. But suddenly what will happen, it will bounce back. Spring ka, you know, the elasticity, it has got its tensile strength. Because of that, uska stretching jo bhi hai, wo unexpected hai aapke liye. Sometimes I'm talking, okay, ek example de rahi hun. So uska reaction, aap jab usko apply karte ho, to wo stretch ho jayega. Okay, some input if you apply, it gets stretched. Force, assume karo ki aap force apply kar rahe ho. Stretch ho jayega, wo expand ho jayega. After that, after when you apply the force, it will come back to its normal position. Okay, in the system working, during the working of the system, aap spring ko apply kar rahe ho force, wo expand ho gaya, and after some time it will come back to its original position. So backlash is a reaction from the system back when you apply any input. So because of such some circumstances also, errors may be created. So the steady state error, how you can define this is, the steady state error, it is the value of the error signal when t tends to infinity. So what is this? We have seen this closed loop system. This is your R of S. Okay, roughly, let me draw it quickly. So this is your G of S, forward transfer function. This is your output, a controlled output. Ye aapka feedback hai, H of S. B of S. Now, if you see, here we write error signal E of S. Okay, so what is this error signal? Jo aap expect kar rahe ho, jo aap reference input de rahe ho, jo aapka actual output aa raha hai, in dono ka difference error signal hai. Okay, for example, take again the same good old example, 60 kilometer aapka target hai, speed cover up. आप अचीव 50 किलोमीटर कर रहे हो, दोनों के बीच का डिफरेंस आपका एरर सिग्नल होगा. एंड स्टेडी स्टेट एरर इज व्हाट? इट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस एरर सिग्नल व्हेन टी टेंड्स टू इंफिनिटी. मींस जब सिस्टम आपका स्टेडी स्टेट में आ जाएगा, टी टेंड्स टू इंफिनिटी, ड्यूरिंग दैट वट एवर द एरर वैल्यू, एरर सिग्नल वैल्यू इज देयर, दैट वी कॉल इट स्टेडी स्टेट एरर. ओके, hope you understood this. It's very important. This is the definition of error, steady state error. Ye error signal ka value hai at what? At time t tends to infinity. Jab time bahut infinite rahega, jab aapka system steady state mein aa jayega, that time whatever error value you get in the system, that is called steady state error. So here I have given you the figure. You can see I can get the expression here. ये आपका closed loop system है. You can observe in few of the textbooks, they have taken this whatever expression now I'm going to deal with H of S considering as a one block. Okay, but what I have considered here, I have taken this as a unity feedback system, जहाँ पे H of S one रहेगा. But in most of the textbooks, you get दोनों combination में आपको मिलेंगे, या तो H of S एक ब्लॉक सेपरेटली कंसीडर होगा, और टेकिंग अ सिंगल लाइन इंडिकेटिंग इट इज अ यूनिटी फीडबैक सिस्टम. सो फ्रॉम दिस ब्लॉक डायग्राम वी नो दैट द हाउ टू फाइंड द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन, सी बाय आर, आउटपुट बाय इनपुट इज द फॉरवर्ड गेन डिवाइडेड बाय 1 प्लस फॉरवर्ड गेन इनटू द फीडबैक गेन. यहां पे फीडबैक गेन वैल्यू 1 है, सो जी इनटू एच. नाउ इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द फिगर, ये तो एक हो गया, वी नो दिस ऑलरेडी. फ्रॉम द फिगर यू कैन सी व्हाट इज दिस एरर सिग्नल, सॉरी नॉट एरर सिग्नल, व्हाट इज दिस आउटपुट सी ऑफ एस. यू कैन सी ये जो फॉरवर्ड पाथ में जो ये आपको एलिमेंट्स दिख रहे हैं, यू हैव जी ऑफ एस हियर. कोई भी सिस्टम को अगर आप let me take this. आप सपोज इनपुट एक्स दे रहे हैं, ये जी गेन है, सिस्टम का गेन है, ये आपका वाई आउटपुट है. सो हाउ विल यू राइट आउटपुट वाई? वाई इज इक्वल टू इनपुट टाइम्स गेन, और गेन इज इक्वल टू आउटपुट बाय इनपुट. यू राइट दिस. सो इन द सेम वे इफ यू ऑब्जर्व, होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस. सो इन द सेम वे इफ यू ऑब्जर्व दिस पार्ट, आपका आउटपुट सी है, इनपुट इज एरर. सो हाउ कैन यू राइट द आउटपुट? सो आउटपुट इज, इनपुट क्या है? ई है, मल्टीप्लाइड बाय गेन. सो यू कैन राइट दिस आउटपुट सी एज ई इंटू जी फ्रॉम द फिगर. नाउ व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस वैल्यू ऑफ सी हियर. ट्रांसफर फंक्शन के इक्वेशन में, न्यूमरेटर में आप उसको सब्स्टिट्यूट कर लो. ई इंटू जी is equal to divided by R of S as it is, G of S divided by 1 plus G of S. Or you can see G of S both in the LHS and RHS, they gets cancelled. You'll be left with E by R is equal to 1 divided by G of S. Further, I had forgotten actually. So arrow mark, देखिए मैंने यहाँ पे लिखा है. You can see. Further continuation of this, E of S will be, ये जो भी आपका RHS है, take the multiplication. So I have taken here, multiplying this, denominator term को RHS में ले जाओ. और ये जो है आपका Laplace transformation में है, S domain में आपका error signal है. But if I want it in time domain, I have to apply inverse Laplace transform. So E of S will be, inverse of E of S is E of T. The error signal in time domain, which is equal to, ये जो भी आपका RHS value है, इसको आपको Laplace inverse apply करना है, okay? और in short, if you remember, while dealing with the first order and second order system, we have taken this error signal, steady state error, ESS. ESS indicates a steady state. So ESS is limit of this error signal, limit as t tends to infinity. So this is the definition. You can see, ये जो मैंने red draw किया है यहाँ पे, this is matching with this definition, what I have given you here. The steady state error is the value of error signal when t tends to infinity. So the same holds good here. You can see, steady state error is the value of the error signal when a time t tends to infinity. Okay, now how can you find this steady state error? You have Fourier ya fir Z transformations mein aapne initial value final value theorem padha hoga while dealing with the properties. Okay, so one of the properties, final value theorem. Okay, shayad Z transform ne aapne padha hoga. Similarly applying in the S domain. So how can I take this error, steady state error? This steady state error, what I have taken, applying the final value theorem. The final value theorem is this. Whenever you go for time domain to frequency domain, here time is infinity, S domain it will become zero. And error E will be capital E of S. There is a multiplication factor, yes. तो ये आपका फाइनल वैल्यू थ्योरम होगा. तो यहाँ पे ई ऑफ एस, इंस्टेड ऑफ ई ऑफ एस, आई कैन सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस आर ऑफ एस डिवाइडेड बाय 1 प्लस जी ऑफ एस. तो ये आपका इक्वेशन है, जनरल इक्वेशन फॉर स्टेडी स्टेट एरर. सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द हेडिंग. व्हाट इट सेज, द टाइटल यू कैन सी, द टाइटल सेज steady state error. So we have to study about the steady state error. We have seen the definition, how you can write the expression for steady state error. Still we need to find go for the understanding of error constants. Okay, now from this figure, from this equation that we have got just now, steady state error, you can observe few things. ESS has a value in the numerator R of S, in the denominator G of S. You can see I'm taking this and this first and the last expression. E of ESS, steady state error, it is dependent on the input R of S and the gain or the open loop transfer function G of S. So you can observe from this expression, your steady state error is dependent on two values. One is the input, the other one is G of S. So observe that the steady state error, it depends on the input as well as the forward transfer function G of S. That's what I have commented below. Now, as in the expression, you have this R of S. So what is this R of S? It is the input applied in the S domain, R of S. Agar aap time domain mein loge, so it will become R of T. And we have seen some four to five different standard test signals we have seen. Like unit step hai, ramp hai, impulse hai. Then what else? You have parabolic function. So for those different test signals, how your system behaves. So just like that, even error, steady state error also, we can try to determine this value for different inputs. R of S, क्योंकि आप expression में देख सकते हो, it has got both G of S and R of S. So आपका error, steady state error, R of S पे depend करता है and G of S पे depend करता है. So let us see, अगर मैं R of values different test signals लूँगी, तो what I will get the value for ESS. So the expressions for steady state error for different standard test signals as the input, they are as follows. So some 2 to 3 examples we have seen here. We can see here in the next. So what I will do here, in the first, you can see first applied input is unit step signal. So when I apply unit step input to your system, what value of error I will get? So that we need to check here. In bracket you can see it is also called static position error constant. So now the concept of error constants are coming. First half is steady state error, second half of the title is error constants. So let us see what are those. So whenever you apply unit step input to your system, whatever error is generated, in that some constant we get, that we call it error position error constant. Okay, so let us start the equation. We know that whenever we apply unit step as the input, that is R of T, jo input ka symbol hai R of T, it is U of T, and a unit step signal is defined for amplitude 1. And if I take the transfer, that is Laplace transforms of R of T, it will become R of S, which is 1 by S. Hope it is visible clearly to all of you. So this is 1 by S. Now, just now we have derived this equation, the steady state error, ESS, by the final value theorem, limit S into E of S, or limit S into R of S by 1 plus G of S. Remember, here, in the denominator, I have got only G of S. Why? What is the reason? Because when I'm considering the block diagram here, I have taken unity feedback. Uske liye, in the denominator term of your error equation, observe karo yahan pe, you have got only G of S. Agar aap H of S loge in the block diagram, your expression will be something like this, into H of S. Yahan pe humne H of S nahi liya hai because it is unit, 1. H of S is equal to 1. Okay, now coming to the further continuation. So what I will do here, I will apply R of S as 1 by S. Unit step ke liye R of S is given by 1 by S. So I will substitute that. S gets cancelled. You will be left with limit, numerator mein 1 rahega, 1 divided by 1 plus G of S. Or how you can write this? See, you have constant 1, you have constant 1. So what I will do, I will apply this limit to this term, G of S. Okay, 1 to constant hai, so only G of S is remaining here. So I will apply limit only to this G of S. Fine? because even if you take limit of this 1, it is a constant term, so it will equal to 1 only. 1 plus, you will get the limit of g of s. अगर मैं मेरे ब्लॉक डायग्राम में यूनिटी फीडबैक ना लेके एच ऑफ एस अगर कंसिडर करूंगी, सो व्हाट विल बी दिस जी ऑफ एस इनटू एच ऑफ एस. ओके, रिमेंबर दैट मॉडिफिकेशंस यू शुड बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. हियर आई हैव गॉट ओनली जी ऑफ एस टर्म बिकॉज यूनिटी फीडबैक सिस्टम इज देयर. सपोज यू टेक एच ऑफ एस इन योर ब्लॉक डायग्राम, एवरी टर्म एवरी स्टेप हियर यू कैन सी जी ऑफ एस शुड बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाई एच ऑफ एस. ओके, now substitute here because I'm applying the limit, it will become g of 0. Okay, and this limit s tends to 0 g of s, we call this by some name, that is kp, some constant. Jo bhi aap manipulate karoge limit apply karke, g of s jo system ka open loop transfer function hai, forward transfer function hai, wo leke agar aap s domain mein s tends to 0 karoge, when you apply the limit, whatever answer you get, I will make that equal to kp. I mean, I'm giving that value some, you know, constant kp, and that value kp, which is equal to limit of g of s into 1. Okay, because h of s is 1 into 1, this is called position error constant. So when we study error signal, steady state error, when unit step signal is your input, then we get a constant called position error constant. Remember, steady state value, when you apply unit step signal, we call it positional error constant. Okay, this is one type of error. Still, we will check. अगर मैं इनपुट चेंज करती हूँ, इफ आई चेंज द इनपुट एंड इफ आई ट्राई टू फाइंड व्हाट इज द एरर वैल्यू, लेट्स सी व्हाट वी गेट. होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस. टॉकिंग अबाउट द सेकेंड टर्म, नेक्स्ट टाइम आई विल अप्लाई रैंप सिग्नल एज द इनपुट. रैंप, यू नो ऑलरेडी व्हाट इट इज, लाइक दिस. ओके, अ रैंप सिग्नल इज अप्लाइड एज द टेस्ट सिग्नल, इनपुट टेस्ट सिग्नल. देन इन ब्रैकेट यू कैन सी वी गेट error constant named as static velocity. Earlier it was position, this time it is velocity. Now let me see how the error value comes. We know that for unit ramp input, r of t is nothing but t. Hope you know about this already. Ramp signal is defined by this t. When you take the Laplace transformation, r of s is equal to 1 by s square. Right, and Laplace transform of t is 1 by s square. So we know already this, the equation just now we have seen. Steady state error is given by limit final value theorem, apply karo s into e of s or s into, this is the general equation, r by 1 plus g into 1. Okay, h of s is equal to 1. Now in this numerator part, I will change r of s to 1 by s square because I am applying a ramp. So substitute that, out of these two s powers, one value will get cancelled. So you will be left with 1 by s here, right? 1 by s and remaining as it is. So rearranging these terms, okay, if I rearrange, what I'll get? Taking this multiplication, I have multiplied it here. Now, if you apply the limit, numerator ko aap limit apply karo, 1 hai, 1 hi bachega. Denominator you check, apply the limit, first value yes hai, second value yes into g of yes hai. First value jab aap limit apply karoge, yes tends to 0, first term will become 0. Plus, second term yes into g of yes, so I'm applying the limit to second term. Limit as yes tends to 0, yes into g of yes. And whenever you calculate this for a given g of s, when you apply the limit and when you get the answer, let be that answer equal to kv. And what is this kv? Kv is called limit of s into g of s into 1, because h of s is equal to 1. It is called velocity error constant. So what's the difference? earlier it was, sorry, earlier it was what? Position error constant. See, position error constant. Now it is velocity error constant. Position error kab hoga? Jab aap unit step apply karoge. Position error. And velocity error constant kab hoga? When you apply ramp as the input. Now let me take one more. When I apply unit parabolic input, okay, parabolic function ko agar input apply karenge system ko, let's see what is the error. In bracket you can see it is called static acceleration error constant. Position error, velocity error, acceleration error, three different types. Okay, so unit parabolic function, we have defined this while dealing with different standard test signals in the start of the module 3. We have seen what are the different test signals: impulse, ramp, then a unit step, and parabolic also. So parabolic, how you define? Input r of t is given by t square by 2. We take this parabola, right? T square by 2. If you take the Laplace transformation, you will get r of s is equal to 1 by s cube. Laplace transformation of t square by 2, you can calculate, you will get 1 by s cube. So this is half part. Now talking about error, steady state error value. So the steady state error, we know it is given by final value theorem, and it is given by this. So sorry, it is r. Okay, r of s. So what is r of s this time? It is 1 by s cube. So take these two. 1 s will cancel with this. Out of 3 powers of s, s square will be remained. That I have kept it here. Next step, I will multiply this s square in the denominator. Now, in the next step, when you apply this limit to these two terms, limit of s square as s tends to 0, what you will get? Limit of s square as s tends to 0, you will get 0 only. So, ye jo first term hai, it will become 0. 0 plus second term, limit of s square into g of s. एंड ये जो भी आप कैलकुलेट करोगे लिमिट ऑफ यस स्क्वायर एंड जो भी गिवन आपका ओपन लूप फंक्शन रहेगा ट्रांसफर फंक्शन जी ऑफ यस व्हेन यू गेट दिस आंसर दिस लेट दैट बी इक्वल टू सम कांस्टेंट के ए एंड व्हाट इज दिस कांस्टेंट के ए दिस कांस्टेंट के ए इज कॉल्ड एक्सेलरेशन एरर कांस्टेंट ओके सो वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज अ स्टेडी स्टेट एरर we have got from a block diagram. Okay, let me just quickly show you. Okay, we have seen what is a steady state error. Ek block diagram leke we have seen how to get the error. This with this red box you can see ESSC is limit of e of t, or using the final value theorem we can get steady state error like this. In this you can observe that आपका जो एरर ईएसएस का इक्वेशन है इट इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन आर एंड जी सो दैट्स व्हाई वी विल सी फॉर डिफरेंट आर ऑफ एस वैल्यूज यूनिट स्टेप रैंप एंड पैराबोलिक व्हाट इज ईएसएस सो फर्स्ट टाइम वी हैव सीन यूनिट स्टेप के लिए व्हाट इज द एरर वी कॉल द कांस्टेंट दैट वी गेट एट द एंड वी कॉल इट पोजिशन एरर कंट्रोल स्टेडी स्टेट एरर में एक कॉन्स्टेंट आएगा that is called steady state position error constant. Remember, I am giving you this kp limit of only g of s, but if I change my block diagram and if I take h of s in my block diagram, because in my block diagram currently I am taking h of s as 1, so here only g of s is there, but if I consider h of s, you should convert this, you have to modify this kp equation as limit of s tends to 0 g of s into h of s. Okay, this is about first. Now when I apply ramp input, we call whatever the error constant that comes, we call it velocity error constant. Okay, again the point to be remembered is I am taking this kv, v stands for velocity, first I'll list it out at the end. So what is KV? You have got limit of S into G of S. So remember, again, I have not taken H of S because in my block diagram, H of S is equal to 1. So if the block diagram has H of S, you have to modify this. It should be a G of S into H of S. Okay. And we call this constant as velocity error constant. Similarly, coming to the third, when I apply a parabolic input, whatever constant that comes, it is called acceleration error constant. You can see limit of S square, only G of S is there. So if the block diagram is modified, you should take this G of S into H of S. So let me just list out. When you take unit step signal as the input, jo bhi aapka error, steady state error value aega, in that you get position error constant. If you take ramp signal, your steady state error will get a constant value called velocity error constant. And if you take R of t as a parabolic, that is t square by 2, if you take whatever error, steady state error you get, it will have a constant called Ka, that is acceleration. You can see the subscript P stands for position, V stands for velocity, A stands for acceleration. Okay, so we have seen what is a steady state error, why it is important, what is the expression for ESS, and what is the value of ESS for different inputs, KP, KV and KA, three error constants we have seen. Okay, hope you understood this. Any doubts you can ask me. The next heading is types of a feedback control system. Okay, when this term, the heading comes, very quickly that comes to your mind is open loop and closed loop system, because already in module 1 we have seen what is what different types of feedbacks are there, open loop and closed loop. And in the closed loop feedback hai, to positive feedback and negative feedback aayega dimag mein first wahi aayega. Okay, but here the discussion, what we are doing, it is under steady state errors. So in this, under this heading, again we are going to discuss regarding the errors only, the different error constant values, what we have just now calculated. Agar aap unit step loge to aapko KP aayega, agar aap ramp loge velocity aayega, and if you take parabola, parabolic function, you'll get KA, acceleration error constant. So what we will do, we will try to calculate these values for different types of control systems. Type in the sense, we have got type 0, type 1, type 2, and so on. So ye jo type 0, type 1, type 2, ye jo systems hain, what are these systems? We will try to understand now. Just the brief I'll give you. Control systems, they may be classified according to their ability to follow the different inputs. Hum aise bhi control system ko classify kar sakte hain. We have seen in the module 1 different classifications, time variant, invariant, linear, non-linear, open loop, closed loop, right? Different categories we have seen. Just like that, control system can also be classified depending upon how much they are able to follow these inputs. Jo aap test signals denge, unko kitna follow karenge wo. Like that, we categorize them as type 0, type 1, type 2 systems, and so on. Okay, I have given only 3 here, and so on. You have type 3, type 4, type 5, like that. Now let's see, when you go for open loop transfer function, what is this open loop transfer function? G of S. When you take the block diagram, let me show you here. So in this block diagram, you can see G of S, the forward transfer function without the feedback. So that is your open loop transfer function. So this open loop transfer function, we have two different methods to write that. Open loop transfer functions, of unity feedback. Again, I'm considering h of s is equal to 1. If you consider h of s, you have to write it in the expressions, okay? So open loop transfer functions, we can write them in two ways. One is using time constant form. One more is a pole zero form. I think a pole zero form study kiye ho already. Whenever a transfer function is given in terms of poles and zeros, matlab numerator mein jo bhi aapko factors aayenge, you can see वो आपको जीरोस रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे. डिनोमिनेटर में जो फैक्टर्स रहेंगे वो आपको पोल्स रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे. सो ये फॉर्म आपने शायद जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म्स में पढ़ा होगा. यू हैव प्रोबेबली यू हैव इवन कैलकुलेटेड द इनवर्स जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म एंड यू हैव ट्राइड टू फाइंड, राइट? सो देयर आर टू डिफरेंट वेज टू राइट द ओपन लूप ट्रांसफर फंक्शन, आइदर टाइम कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर्म और पोल जीरो फॉर्म. सो वी विल बी फोकसिंग हियर ऑन दिस. We are in your textbook. First form is being used. Time constant form. You can see yahan pe k hai. This k, it can be ka, kv, kp, right? And 1 plus tz1 by into s, tz2 into s. Ye jo hai, t values, they are time constants. Okay? And one important thing here to remember is this term. S raised to n. So what is this n? N indicates how many number of poles are there at zero, at zero position. वो आपको n value determine करेगा. S raised to n. Okay, I have not written here, but I'm giving you generally. N indicates the number of pole values at zero position. That is something like this. Pole is indicated by cross mark, right? So if I have some system s into s plus 1 into s plus something, aisa kuch ek aapka ek function hai aapke paas, you can observe what is the power of this s. S raised to 1, in the sense one pole is there at the zero position. Okay, so ye information aapko, ye jo power hai usse milega. Now talking about s raised